Race 8 of the 2016 AST Voltson Super Truck season takes us to the state of Illinois for the first time in the series' short history. We are at the DuQuoin State Fairgrounds this week, the only racetrack on the calendar that the series has not visited before. The one-mile dirt track is going to provide a new challenge to these drivers and teams. We have, of course, raced at Winston Speedway and Terre Haute Action Track for the past couple of years, but DuQuoin is twice the size of Terre Haute, much, much faster, and is one of the few one-mile dirt tracks in the country. Most of the drivers in the field, therefore, don't have any experience at this type of track. And with the season finale at Berlin Raceway just a matter of weeks away, the uncertain nature of this race has the potential to really shake up the fight for the championship. On pole position for the race is Riley Durbin in truck number 3, who leads the 29-truck field down to the start. This is a new record for the greatest number of trucks to start a short track race in the series. That is if 1 mile falls within your definition of short track. On the outside of the front row is Daryl Quick in the 82, who is trying to stay alongside Durbin through the first couple of corners. The 3-truck clears him at the end of the first lap, and now Camden Rhodes moves his way into second place, but they take the yellow flag. The caution is out on lap number 1, and let's take a look at what brought it out. In the midfield, Mary Brousseau makes contact with Zach Churchill, and they go down into Amberlee Weiss, turning her up into Churchill. It puts the 84 on the wall. Michael McKinley and Brianna Prinzhorn get involved as well. Both of them hit the 25 as she went spinning down the backstretch. There's a couple more cars involved in this. And Michael McKinley, looking at the replay, hit the back of the 7 truck after she hit the 25. There's John White and Alex DeFranco. White also hit Brousseau, and they were not able to avoid hitting the 99M. McKinley, one of the points contenders at this stage in the season. We're on board Kevin Thompson. Speaking of points contenders, he took over the points lead last week at Galesburg and nearly got caught up in this. With some very heads-up driving, however, he's able to avoid the crash. On the restart, Camden Rhodes goes for the lead right away on Riley Durbin, moving to the inside and taking the top spot. Rhodes has led in multiple races throughout the season, but has not visited Victory Lane. In fact, none of the Operation JM cars have visited Victory Lane yet, which is quite a surprise considering that they won literally half of the races in last year's season. Archer Helms and Hunter Blaze do battle for position in the midfield. Helms is running a new paint scheme this week, the 153 truck, now running the colors of his sister's Girl Scout troop. It's a very nice looking truck that he's got there, but he's going to get into trouble when he makes contact with Lester McPhail, puts himself, McPhail, and Zach Churchill into the outside wall off of turn number 2, and down the backstretch he gets hit by John White, and you see Kevin Thompson's involved. Truck number 90, your points leader, gets into trouble on lap number 7, the second caution of the race. Looking at the replay, Zach Churchill and his teammate Brianna Prinzhorn were both in the wall, but that didn't have anything to do with it seems. Helms turned pretty far down the track and into the side of the 404 truck, turning them both into Zach Churchill and the outside wall. And Kevin Thompson does not get so lucky this time around after managing to avoid the first accident of the race. He slowed down for the accident but got hit by Wilson Timothy, who could not slow down in time. And the 90 truck is not going to receive much damage, but it's obviously going to set him back. And Timothy, meanwhile, has to pit to get his damage repaired. Timothy, another one of the championship contenders, so this accident could have some big implications on the title fight. After the restart, Daryl Quick goes for second place on Riley Durbin as Camden Rhodes speeds off into the distance. But here comes John Bennett on Quick's outside, trying to take the third spot from him now. Bennett off to a very good start after having a rather poor run last week at Galesburg. And off the corner, Quick is still looking to the inside of the 3 despite having to fend off the 58. Here at the back of the field, we have a number of drivers who have gotten caught up in the first two cautions. Amberlee Weiss is going to go to the inside of Zach Churchill and make it 4 wide with herself and Kevin Thompson in the middle. Wilson Timothy on the inside, and oh, there's another crash! Weiss piled into the back of John White, who hit the 94. Juan Cortez was already crashing further down the track. Let's take a look at what happened to him. He and Brianna Prinzhorn make contact, go into the outside wall, and Cortez goes flying into the air, upside down, and then gets hit by the 06 as the rest of the field goes by. Archer Helms got a piece of that as well. That was a violent crash, and really sums up the way that Juan Cortez's rookie campaign has gone. Here's a look at the replay. The 94 team seems to either DNF or DNQ every week, and nothing has gone right for them this year. Likewise with Brianna Prinzhorn, she has a lot of crashes and a lot of DNQs of her own. We're on board Prinzhorn right now and about to get the same view of Cortez's truck turning over that she did. A very scary accident for her it must have been, but one that she brought upon herself. She turned down into the 94 truck in the corner, obviously not intentionally, but it is going to take a few more trucks out of the race. Cortez, White, and Weiss are all going to have to retire from the event. As Rhodes continues to lead on the restart, Riley Durbin was successfully able to fend off the challenges from his competitors. Rhodes is, of course, one of the Terre Haute Dirt, or Action Track, excuse me, racers in the field, so it's no surprise to see him doing well here, especially considering how fast he's been all season long. As we look behind him now at the fierce battles for the second position, as Danny Vigo has now joined these three trucks in the fight for the second spot on the track, John Bennett trying to get around Quick and Durbin at the same time, but gets a bad run into turn number one, and here comes Quick sweeping around the outside of Bennett and to the inside of Durbin, and he's going to move himself into the second spot, but Durbin's not going to let Quick keep the position if he can help it. He goes back to the inside, down the front straightaway, and Danny Vigo is running right behind him trying to follow Durbin through, but the three car can't find the momentum to get around him. Still running side by side and two by two down the back straightaway, these four drivers running very hard for the second position and allowing Rhodes to pull away at the same time, although it's probably very fun for the fans to watch. Durbin clears Quick, but Vigo, as soon as he gets the opportunity, blasts around the three and moves into the second spot himself. Operation JM now has the trucks running 1-2. This is by far their best race of the year so far, but John Bennett is trying to break up that 1-2 run by going to the inside. He almost drifts up into Vigo off of turn number 2, but is going to pull ahead of him down the backstretch and clear him into turn number 3. Bennett now sets his sights on the 62 truck further down the track. As the battle for a second begins to settle down a little bit, it looks like we may have another challenger on his way to the front. Hunter Blaze in truck number 71 started the race all the way back in 20th, but avoided trouble in the early string of cautions that we got, and is now trying to get around Samantha Spires, that is for the 6th position. Blaze has had one of the fastest trucks on the track ever since the restart, and as this green flag run goes on, he has been storming his way through the field. Just behind these two drivers is the battle for 8th between Kathy Gargalak and Rachel Kowalczyk. These two women have been very consistent performers in the series in their limited schedules. They haven't really contended for wins, but they've been regular top 10 finishers. Behind them, we have Adam Ramirez in the 86 truck running in 10th. He leads a 4-truck group that includes Nick Moss, Jenny Jackson, and Brian Kelly. Jackson, of course, coming off of her first career victory last week at Galesburg. These four drivers all finished in the top 10 at Winston Speedway, except for Ramirez, who finished in 11th, and that was his debut race. All of them are having average runs so far here today. Further back, we have Jeffrey Jackson, who runs 14th, in a group with Wilson Timothy, Daniela Jacobson, and Chris Washer. Timothy has slowly but surely been recovering from having to pit under the second caution, now trying to work his way into the 15th spot. Hunter Blaze has managed to catch up to the drivers running in the top 5. He now trails Riley Durbin by inches down the backstretch, and wastes no time making a move for the spot into turn number 3, and he clears him very quickly. That was a decisive pass from Blaze, his truck still showing a blistering pace. He goes after Darrell Quick just a few laps later for the 4th position. Blaze has not had a very good season in the AST Wolfson Super Trucks this year by his standards. He has not been in contention for as many wins due in part to some bad luck, so a run like this today is just what the Gravity Racing Incorporated team needs. Back at the head of the field, Camden Rhodes is opening up the lead that he already has over John Bennett and Danny Vigo, leaving his competition in the dust, quite literally speaking. Rhodes only has raced at Terre Haute for a couple of years as opposed to his teammates, who both have many years of experience at the track, but he's taken very well to the dirt tracks in the Bolton Super Trucks. He's going to put Archer Helms a lap down, the 153 truck, the first damaged truck to fall off the lead lap. And now here comes the battle for second upon him. Danny Vigo's trying to get around John Bennett, and they split the 153 truck down the backstretch, not letting him get in the way. And they continue on as if nothing happened. Vigo's going to clear Bennett, but as the rest of the field goes to lap Helms, he is not going to be able to stay out of the way of Ed Ramirez. And Ramirez is going to lose a couple of spots to Nick Moss and Jenny Jackson. In fact, it's going to take him a full lap to get around the 86, and at this point they're also lapping Zach Churchill. Ramirez has lost a lot of ground on the drivers with whom he was just running. The battle for second comes across some more lap traffic, and Danny Vigo's going to sideswipe Brianna Prinzhorn while trying to put her a lap down. They both break loose, but neither lose control, and the battle for second continues between these two drivers. Bennett and Vigo have been absolutely going at it ever since the restart, as we've showed several times, and neither of them are content with running third. It's nice to see that this track has turned out to be so racy this weekend when the series has never been here before. V the maintenance crew at the DuQuoin State Fairgrounds have done a very good job, although it's hard to see the inside line not being the preferred groove. The inside's almost exclusively preferred at this track in pretty much every other race that's run here, typically speaking, but today we've seen the outside and the middle lane be the fast way around the track. That's the nature of these dirt tracks, though. They vary on a day-to-day basis and really throughout the duration of a race, as Vigo takes the second spot back from John Bennett as this fierce battle rages on. It's a bit deeper in the field, but here is another battle that has been going on since not long after the restart, as Wilson Timothy has still not been able to find his way around Daniela Jacobsen, and they're going to make contact, go into the outside wall, and Timothy's upside down, turning over back onto its wheels, and that's the end of the day for Wilson Timothy. Let's take a look at the replay. He's the second truck to get turned over in the same fashion today, and this time it was the car on the inside that drifted up the track across the front of Jacobsen and put himself on the outside wall. That's going to take Timothy out of the race and erase the huge lead that Camden Rhodes had, although as you can see, he's got three lap trucks as a buffer between himself and second place Danny Vigo for the restart, which comes with just seven laps to go. Mary Brousseau, Alex DeFranco, and Kevin Thompson are all in the way, and Vigo and the rest of the leaders are going to have to find a way to get around them immediately if they are going to have a chance to put up a fight to Rhodes, and that's exactly what Vigo's going to do. He goes to the inside of Thompson right on the start and brings Hunter Blaze with him. Blaze got around Bennett before Bennett could find his way past the 90 truck, and now here they go past DeFranco and Brousseau. Vigo with Blaze in tow, now clear and in second and third place. Bennett now trying to get around the lap trucks himself. Durbin and Quick are still in the thick of it though, still stuck in the lap traffic. Durbin takes to the inside where he has a clear shot, but now suddenly finds himself sandwiched between two lap trucks while Quick goes around the outside. Rachel Kowalczyk and Samantha Spires trying to take advantage and gain some positions of their own. As now DeFranco gets out of the way, here comes Durbin back to the inside as Kowalczyk and Spires are stuck now. It's a very hectic scramble to try and get around these lap trucks, and now that the rest of the top five drivers have done so, they begin to work on chasing down Camden Rhodes. With as fast as the 62 truck has been all day, they are going to need to make something happen, and quickly so, if they are going to have a chance at winning the race. And Hunter Blaze, trying to make that happen himself, but he's going to run wide in turn one and almost drift up into the outside wall. That leaves the door open for John Bennett to make a move to the inside. Bennett trying to work his way back up to third place after getting stuck behind the lap trucks on the restart. And through turns number 3 and 4, it looks like he's going to sweep around the 71, moving back into position number 3. And now a couple laps later, he's coming after Danny Vigo for second, resuming the battle that they've been having the entire race. And they rub doors a little bit through turn number 2. You can see that Rhodes is still within striking distance, but they aren't exactly closing in on him while they're racing side by side like this. Bennett is going to clear Vigo through turn 3, just as he did to Blaze a couple of laps earlier, trying to chase down the 62, but he's running out of time. Rhodes is taking the white flag and beginning the final mile of the race. The 18-year-old has had a very impressive debut season in this series. His one race in 2015 was a second-place finish in which he led many laps, and now, through the final corners, it's clear sailing for Camden Rhodes. Operation JM, as we mentioned, has not been to victory lane since Danny Vigo won at Galesburg last year, and the team's sixth career victory comes with its third driver. Camden Rhodes wins at the DuQuoin State Fairgrounds. Congratulations to Rhodes and everyone on the 62 team. John Bennett finishes a very impressive second place finish, his best finish since his win at MIS, and Danny Vigo makes it two Operation JM cars on the podium. It was a great day for that team, as well as for Gravity Racing Incorporated, as Hunter Blaze scores his best result of the year in 4th. Daryl Quick finishes in 5th with Riley Durbin, the pole sitter, in 6th. Durbin will be racing in the FARC Elite Series event at this track in 3 weeks' time, and gain valuable experience here today. Kathy Gargalak finishes in 7th, scoring into the top 10, likewise with Rachel Kowalczyk. Those two battled for that position for most of the race, with Samantha Spires, who finishes in 9th, another top 10 run for Spires, and Nick Moss in 10th, gets another top 10 for himself and Moss Motorsports.